Students, all of you got that Google Classroom invitation, no? Anybody who not got, you tell me. Once again, I'll send the invitation of Google Classroom. And why today's strength is very less? Out of 53 students, only 35 are there. Why? It's already 9:35, no? I'll wait another 1 minute and then we'll start. Students, put one message in your unofficial group, no? You put one message, tell everybody to join the class immediately. Yes, good morning all. The students I have sent a link for Google Classroom of software testing class. See students, from now onwards, whatever the assignment, whatever I give you, you have to submit to that Google Classroom only. No, don't send any mails. In that Google Classroom, I'll create the assignments. To that assignment only you have to send the students. 1 minute. Okay, to that Google Classroom only you have to send the assignment. Yes, students, I'll start my class. Can you see the screen? Can you all see the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, students, in last class we were seeing the behavior of the program. Behavior is nothing but how the program executes or how the program behaves. Here I have given a small example, and in the behavior we have also learned that the program can be shown or the program can be specified in a several ways, that is in a normal natural language or like English like statements we can write, and you can also describe or you can also specify using a state diagram. State diagram is nothing but a flowchart, like flowchart diagram. In flowchart diagram, how we represent, in last class I shown you the representation of flowchart, to find largest of two numbers. Yes, correct, no? In last class we have seen. And we can also show, by a formal mathematical statement. Using a mathematical statements also we can show. Yes, students, a test, to write any test case or to develop any program, the basic is maths. If you know the logic of that program, that logic is nothing but a mathematical statement only. Is when we say largest of two numbers, how we are telling a largest of two numbers? Using that mathematical, see here we are specifying largest of two numbers. This is nothing but, this is maths only. This logic is nothing but the mathematical statement only. We are checking whether this x is less than y. If this condition is true, if x is less than y means y is a greater number, y is a larger number, so that value will be stored in the variable z, else the x value will be stored in the variable x, so the finally the output of z will be displayed. So this is a small example I had explained you for the program behavior. One more example I'll explain. Assume that you have created a application or you have created a project. In that project, your home page contains a menu bar. See, students, in the menu bar I have given some of the options, that is file. When you go to word, in word also you have so many file, view, design, format, so many options are there, no? When you click on file, a drop down list will come, correct? And when you click on edit, a drop down list will come. What information or what option the drop down list will be contained, whatever we have given during development time, whatever the developer gives the options, those options will be present in file, in edit, tool, windows, whatever. Next, if you give view, design, format, if you go on increasing the options in the menu bar, so if you increase options in the menu bar, even if I click on file, see students, when I click on file, there should be some list of options inside it. If we don't have a list of options, then directly only a single option you can give. So here on a file, if I click, a drop down list is coming, that is new file if you want to open, already if you have created any file, after some time once again you want to access that file, then this open option will be there, close, and so on. Save as in file, we may have so many options, no? Save as in file, like when you click on open again, some options will be there. Recently, few of the documents, if you use my MS Office in Word, and in Word you can see, so these options in Word, PowerPoint, suppose if you forgot the file name, recently you used a file name XYZ, if you forgot the file name, when you click on file, when you go to open, a recent opened file list will be there. Yes, students, you observed this. So this is the, like this, see students, see here, I know what are the menu, in the menu bar, whatever the options I have given. Correct, no? I know whatever the options I have given. Here I am cross checking whether my program is executing whatever the options I have given or not. This is how, see, when I click on edit, then it should display a drop down menu. It should display a drop down list. What the drop down list contains? Whatever the options I have given. whatever the options I have given. Sometimes maybe some error while writing a code, maybe if you have done some mistake, then when you click on this file, a drop down list will not come. When you click on this file, a drop down list will not come. Why? Maybe some syntax error you have done, maybe some logical error or logical mistake you have done. So if any program is, if your program has error, then definitely this list will not come. If your program doesn't have error, then if your program is executing successfully, then this list will be displayed. If your program is showing this list, then we have to assume that our program doesn't have any error. It is running successfully. Correct? Correct, students. This is a behavior. This is a behavior of my program. How my program should behave. How my program should behave when I click on tools. In tools, whatever the options I have given, it should display all the options. If I know, if I predict the behavior of the program, then only I can tell that the observed behavior is matching with the desired behavior. Correct? No? If my predicted or if my desired behavior is matching with the observed behavior, then I can say there is no error or there is no mistake in the program. My program is executing successfully. Correct? You understood what is program behavior? Yes, students, how my program, this assume that this application I have developed. So before executing this application, I know that when I click on file, what option it should display. When I click on edit, what option it should display. When I click on tools, when I click on windows, what are the options it should display. When it is displaying whatever the option I have desired, if it is displaying the same drop-down menu or same drop-down list, then I can say the program is behaving properly. The program doesn't have any errors. The behavior is matching. The observed behavior is matching with the desired behavior. Yes, students, understood? Correct, no? If I click on edit, if the list is not coming, if the list is not coming, then I should think that the program is not behaving properly, not executing properly. Why? There will be n number of reasons. There may be n number of reasons. Maybe you have done some syntax error or logical error. Maybe you have not closed the flower press. If you have not closed the flower press properly, also then you don't get a output. If any error, see, the meaning is if any error or any mistake in the in your program, only then you will not get a desired output. If there is no error, if there is no mistake, then definitely you will get a desired output. See, in the last example also, if the logic is correct, if the logic is correct, then we'll get a desired output. If the logic is wrong, then we'll not get a desired output. So that's why here one simple example I have taken, and here one a project like example I have taken. This is a menu driven application. Yes, correct. No, this is a menu driven application. In this menu driven application, this menu bar contains so many options. Under this file also, we have a drop down list. Or you can say pull down menu. Pull down menu. If it is executing properly, then the, we have to assume that a program is behaving properly. My program doesn't have any errors. So it is executing for all the cases. Or it is executing for all the possible inputs. See, students, when my program executes for all the possible inputs, then only a tester will say that the program doesn't have any error. It is success. It is executing successfully. If for any of the input, if it is not giving a correct output, then the tester will tell that a failure in the program, because for so and so input, it is not giving the correct output. So this is the reason why we appoint a tester. Why? Because we have to test for all the possible ways of input. The students, here a same, whatever the program we have seen, whatever this here we have seen, the same thing is represented in the form of a diagram. The same thing is represented in the form of a diagram. That is with the step by step. Yes, students, here T0, S0. Can you see this T and S, students? This is T and this is S. Can you see? Yes, students, can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
यस मैम।
ओके हियर ये स्टूडेंट्स हियर टी इज नथिंग बट टास्क इनिशिएटेड बाय द यूजर हियर टी एंड यस टू ऑप्शंस आर देयर टी इज नथिंग बट टास्क इनिशिएटेड बाय द यूजर एंड यस इज अ एप्लीकेशन स्टेट सो व्हाट इज द स्टेट ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन और व्हाट इज द बिहेवियर ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन So first T0 here the start of the application. First the application will start. See this the previous this is the same example I am explaining here in a pictorial form. First the application will start. Then expecting a user input. Expecting a hey, students if you you don't okay. Expecting the user input. What is the user input? The user should click on either on file, either on tools, or either on edit or either on window. Correct? No. Here we are touching the application. First, we'll start the application. Then, the program will expect a user input. If the user is clicking on Windows, then it should display the options present in the window. Menu. If the user click on tool, then it should display the or it should give the drop down list of whatever the options are there in the tool. Or if I click on edit, see means edit, then whatever the sub options are there or drop down list under are there under edit, so it should display. So it will expecting the user input. Assume that the user input is edit. Assume that user input is edit, but here okay. If you have confusion, then I'll take this only. Then user clicks on file. Yes, students, the input is what? The input is user is clicking on file. So this is task one. Correct? Correct, students, you are getting. This is task one or job one. Then a pull down menu displays. See, this is a status. When you click on file, what happens? That happening is nothing but a status. When you are doing something is nothing but a task initiated by the user. The task initiated by the user is represented by T, and the state of the application is represented by S. So when a user is clicking on file, that is a task. When a user clicks on file, then what will happen? A pull down menu displays. So that is this is from the application end. See, clicking on the file is from the user end, and displaying the drop down list is from the application end. So the state of the application is it is displaying the drop down list, or it is displays a pull down menu. Then the second task, what the user is doing. Second task, what the user is doing? The user is clicking on open. The user is clicking on open. When the user click on open, then what happens? Open will be highlighted. Open will be highlighted, and user releases the menu. User leaves the menu. Oh, sorry, mouse. User leaves the mouse. Then whichever is the current file in the or whichever is the current directory visible, so that will be displayed. Correct, no, student? The same thing happens now. When you click on file, a drop down list will come. When you click on open, then what happens? A current directory it will be displayed, or current file it will display. Yes, understood. Understood here how the program is how program behavior is yes students please respond
yes ma'am
Students, you don't get confused. There is no much difference between this and this. Here, when you click on, here when you click on the application, what happens? This is there, and here the internally how it works. Internally how it works, that is that I have explained. Next is the observation and analysis. Yes, student, is it important or not, observation and analysis? Come on, please respond. Observation and analysis.
Yes, ma'am, it is required.
Why? How?
Ma'am, if we observe only, we'll come to know, no, ma'am, errors and all.
Yes, exactly. If you observe only, see, only observe. And any other answer? Any other answer? Yes, students, if you take a complex program, or if you take any simple program, the important things are observation and analysis. Observation and analysis. If you take an example of small addition of two number programs, when you execute the program, you will observe the behavior. Correct? No? Observing behavior is nothing but checking the output. When you give A is equal to 5, B is equal to 10, then what should be the output? The output should be 15. That we know. How we know? When you know the basic mathematics. When you know the basic mathematics, then definitely a developer or the tester will be knowing what will be the output. So when you execute the program, when you observe the behavior, when you observe the output of the program, then you can analyze. Then you can analyze about the program. So that's why here the first step is observation. In the behavior of the program, the first step is observation and the second step is analyze. Yes. If you take a last example, the file example, when you click on file option, it should display the drop-down list. The drop-down list contains open, close, new. So the next, instead of open, if it is showing some other options, instead of open, close, save as, if it is showing view, design, if it is showing that option, then I'll analyze whether the behavior of the program is correct or not. Whether the behavior of the program is correct or not. When I'll come to know the behavior of the program is right or wrong, when I can be able to analyze the program, when I know the observed behavior and the desired behavior. Correct? No? When I know the observed output and the behaved output. When I know both, only then I can be able to analyze the program. So the first step is observation of the behavior, and the second step, one analyze the observed behavior. We have to analyze whether the observed behavior is right or wrong. Right or wrong. To check if we need to. To check this, we should know both observed behavior and the desired behavior. And it is quite complex. It is quite complex for the larger commercial programs. Hey, students, when you find the behavior of the program for simple programs, then it is very easy. If you try to analyze a large projects or big projects, like commercial large projects, e-commerce projects, e-commerce business project, when you apply the same concept, when you apply the same analysis for Flipkart, definitely you can do, but it takes time. No, you may face some difficulty compared to the program to add two numbers. With the analysis of a Flipkart project is complex, correct? No, because we don't know what type of logic they have given, or what type of requirements they have. Because every day after every minutes the application will be changing, correct? No, students, when you observe Flipkart, there are so many options are there. Flipkart grocery is there. Flipkart, you can also book a flight in Flipkart. You can also buy clothes. You can also buy footwears. You can also buy utensils. So many things you can buy. So if you observe the website properly, after few minutes, the website will be changing. They will be launching new offers. So we have to be very strong in testing and even in the development, so that if anything goes wrong, then immediately we have to find a solution for that. Here, Oracle has given an example. Instead of Oracle, you can take Flipkart also. You can take a example here just to perform the task of analysis. The Oracle is checking some condition. The entity that performs the task of checking the correctness of the observed behavior is Oracle is a name The entity that performs the task of checking the correctness of the observed behavior is known as Oracle. Means to check the correctness of the observed behavior is known as Oracle. Means what? Here we are checking the observed behavior is right or wrong. The observed behavior is correct or wrong. To check that process is known as Oracle. Here we have a diagram. See, students, by seeing this diagram, what you'll understand? Oracle is nothing but checking the behavior of the program, whether the behavior of the program is right or wrong. Yes, here that's why the statement is accessing the program correctness. Yes, students, if my program is not behaving properly, or if my program is not behaving the as I required or as I desire, then I can say some error is there in the program. Then I have to rectify the error, and I have to debug the error. I have to resolve the error. So here the first step is input. Yes, students, you are understanding? You understood what is Oracle? Oracle is nothing but checking the behavior of the program. So the entity that performs the task of checking the correctness of the observed behavior, to check whether the observed behavior is right or wrong. So we call known as a Oracle. Here, input. First statement is input. So when you input a data to the program, the program will do the testing. After testing, the observed behavior means what? Yes, students, what is observed behavior? Observe behavior means what? Observe behavior is nothing but the output which we get. Yes, students, you are understanding or not? So the observed behavior is nothing. If you have any confusion, now also you can make, you can write in one page that the observed behavior is nothing but the output of the program. First, we give the input, then the program will check whether the input is right or wrong. If the program doesn't have error, if the program is executing the without any error, if it is executing, then finally we get the output. That output is nothing but the behavior, observed behavior. Then the oracle process will come. What in the oracle we are doing? We are checking does the observed behavior is matching with the expected behavior. Yes, students, you go back to your second class. In that, I have given the diagram. In the diagram, I have explained, no, observed behavior and desired behavior. So similarly, here also it will check does the observed behavior is matching with the expected behavior. If it is matching with the expected behavior or not. If it is matching, then there is no error. The program is success. The program is success. There is no error. If it is not matching, then you have an error in the program. You need to cross-check your program. So everything we have to write with the explanation. This is like a document. If your program doesn't have error, if your program is executing properly, if both observed behavior and expected behavior is matching, then you have to write the program is executed successfully, both are same, with the explanation. And if it is wrong, if the observed behavior is not matching with the expected behavior, then you have to give a explanation. Yes, students, understood? Yes, understood, students? Students, simply if I
yes,
go
ma'am.
To the next concept, there is no use, because here the concepts are very simple. Here, just we are checking whether the observed behavior is matching with the desired behavior. You just understand the observed behavior is nothing but the output, what we get. The desired behavior is output, what we expect. That is nothing but a desired behavior. No doubt. See, if you don't respond, then I think that you don't have any doubt.
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Yes, next we have execution of the project or program. Execution of project or program. So why I have given project or program is this concept will apply for both for project and for simple program also. That's why I have given execution of project and program. Here, the oracle can also be programmed to design check the behavior of the other program. Yes, when it is checking a output of one program, then definitely it checks the output for other programs also. Correct, no, students? When you are appointing a person to test your hotel management project, a same person or the same test engineer will also do, or he has to do, or he has to test your other application also. He cannot say, I'll check only one project. He cannot say, I'll check only the behavior of only one program, or I'll check only the behavior of only one functionality. Whatever the programs or whatever the applications we are executing, he has to check the possible inputs, and you have to certify whether the program has any error, whether the program is running successfully or not. He has to check. So if you take a simple matrix program also, matrix multiplication program or matrix addition, matrix subtraction, whatever type of program he has to check for all the possible inputs, and he has to tell that whether the program is running successfully or not.
Yes,
Oracle construction. Yes, students, what is Oracle? What is Oracle? In the last few slides back, I have explained what is Oracle. Oracle is nothing but you can assume a person or a machine who can check the behavior of the program. If you have any doubt, you understand like this. Oracle is nothing but Oracle may be a person or a machine that checks the behavior of the program. That checks whether the behavior is right or wrong. Now we have construction of automated Oracle. Yes, automated Oracle is nothing but a machine checking the testing with the help of a machine. The construction of automated Oracle such as the one to check the matrix multiplication program, or a sort program requires the determination of input output relationship. Yes, students, correct? Now before we test whether my program is right or wrong, we should know the input output relationship. When we are checking for matrix multiplication, the input should be only digits, correct? Now the input should be only digit and it is in the form of a matrix. It should be in the form of a matrix. The same matrix input can I use to sort a given numbers? No, I cannot give. So this is a reason why we should, before we execute or before we test our program, we should know that what type of output we are expecting to fulfill my expectation. What type of input I have to give to fulfill my expectation? So that's why we should know the. It is very important to know the relationship between input and output statement. So blindly to check the matrix multiplication program, blindly you cannot give 1 2 3 4 5. There you have to give what is the size of the matrix, correct, students? Whether your matrix is 2 cross 2, 3 cross 3, 4 cross 4, what is the size of first matrix, what is the size of second matrix. Yes, correct? No, we have to think. Simply blindly we cannot write or we cannot test any program. First we should know the input output statement, how input output relationship. When I give the input without giving the size of the matrix, if I just give the two cross two matrix value or 3 cross 3 matrix value, will it execute the program? No, it will not execute the program. It will throw the error. See, student, though the program doesn't have any error, if I don't know how to execute a matrix multiplication program, I don't know how to give the input, then you cannot get a success in the output. Your program will be failure because you don't know how the input should be. So this is the reason why the input is very important. So in general, the construction of automated Oracle is complex undertaking. So if it is a simple project, somehow we can understand what type of input we have to give, what type of output it will display. If it is for a complex program, then it is little difficult. So that's why we go for the automation of the testing or automation of checking. Yes, students, for this diagram you should only answer. Assume that this is a today's assessment. Yes, are you understanding anything by this? any idea you're getting by this? Any idea? Hey students, you take down this diagram in next class. Whatever, by seeing this diagram, whatever is coming to your mind, you have to tell me. You think. See here, input generator. This is a input generator, and this is a H video. This is the database. This is the database, and this is a H video Oracle. This is the H video Oracle. By seeing this diagram, are you getting anything? Are you understanding anything? You know what is H Oracle? Oracle means what? Oracle is nothing but checking the behavior. So here it is checking the behavior of this video. Hey students, in next class you have to tell me by seeing this diagram what you are understanding, what is coming to your mind. Video, H video Oracle, input generator, and the database. Hey students, anything you are understanding in next class you have to tell me. Next we have testing and verification. Testing and verification. A program verification aims at proving the correctness of a program by showing that it contains no error. This is very difficult from testing that aims at uncovering errors in the program. Yes, what is verification? To check whether the whatever the output I have got, whether it is right or wrong. Yes students, for everything we do the verification. When we go to shop with 100 rupees, assume that 20 rupees milk we purchase. When we give 100 rupees to a shopkeeper, then he gives back some change, some amount of money he returns to us. For milk packet, he takes 20 rupees and remaining amount he gives back to us. And if it is 70 rupees, then we'll check that we are verifying whatever, how much ever the money the shopkeeper has given, whether it is right, correct or not, whether he has given the correct amount to me or not. If he is giving 60 rupees or 70 rupees, then I understand that he has done the cheating or by mistake he has not given the money, he has not given the correct money. Again, I'll go back to him and I'll ask. Yes, what I am doing, I am verifying, correct? No, I'm verifying whatever the amount I received from him, whether it is correct or not. According to my assumption, according to my observed behavior, the change I should get is 80 rupees. But the observed behavior is how much? My desired behavior is 80 rupees and the observed behavior is 70 rupees. So it is not matching. After verification, I'll come to a conclusion. It is not matching. Again, I go back to a shop and I'll ask him. So similarly, here, whatever the program you write, whatever the program you execute, if your program is not having any error, then after the, if your program is not having any error, then it will display some output. To that output, we have to verify. After verification, we will come to know the output is right or wrong. So blindly, if we are getting some output, we should not keep quiet. To add two numbers, 4 plus 4, if the output is 6, then we should not think that anyway some output I am getting. No. How we do in our lab internals or lab externals, some output, when you get some output without any verification, you will call external or internal. You will tell that your program, you have executed the program. But when they come and when they verify, when they check your program, then they'll come to know your program, whatever the output you have got, that is not correct. It is not matching with the, it is not matching with the observed. The observed behavior is not matching with the required behavior. The observed behavior is not matching with the required behavior. They'll come to a conclusion. Your program is not correct. Your program is not giving a correct output. So who will do this? All this, the testing process will do this. This testing will be done. Once you do the testing, then you can verify that that is nothing but the verification of the program. Whatever the see students, whatever the program you execute, when you get an output, simply blindly you cannot say that I have got the output and my program is success. You should not say. You have to verify the program. You have to check the you have to verify the output. Whatever the output you are getting, that is right or wrong. So that verification process is very important. Same thing, verification of the program. Next we have test generation strategies. Students, test generation strategy, I'll do it in the next class. Students, you understood no testing and verification? Any doubt? Any doubt, students? Yes, answer your attendance. One, answer your attendance. One, two, answer your attendance. Asta is absent. Two, three.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Yes, ma'am.
Five.
Present, ma'am.
Six. Arbaz, are you there?
Present, ma'am.
Seven.
Present, ma'am.
Eight.
Yes, ma'am.
Nine.
Present, ma'am.
Nine is absent. Benita is absent.
Present, ma'am.
Benita, you are there? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15. 16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18. 9.
18, present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23. 24.